Hello everyone, this is Migo Hunter, and finally we got an IYL match for Morningstar Sanctuary between the one and only Digister and Vengeful Pickle. Digister, if you don't know him already, he's a Rook main, Rook specialist, only plays Rook. Vengeful Pickle plays a variety of characters, but he's known for BBB, Setsuki, Zane, couple others. So we would expect to see Vengeful Pickle playing BBB here, I bet, especially against Rook. And Digister probably, yeah, Digister plays Rook no matter what. So yeah, it'll be an exciting match. I mean, Digister is not is no stranger to bad matchups. But Vengeful Pickle is quite good at BBB and some other characters, so should be an interesting face off. Yeah, Vengeful Pickle got roped into working in Vengeful Pickle's a bit late working a play by forum bot. Pretty sure that's for Yomi 2, where apparently Yomi 2 you take turns instead of playing simultaneous reveal, so that's interesting. So he's just selecting, but he's already got the Rook lock and loaded for sure. Let's see if my prediction's correct. Oh, Panda. Well, still a bad matchup for Rook, but it's nowhere near the level of Rook BBB matchup. I think the nice thing about this matchup is that Rook can block quite comfortably. Get to a nice big hand and then threaten Rock Armor. That's Rook's general game plan against attack heavy characters is to build a large hand and to just armor through their attacks. Usually he trades very well with attacks. Ooh, strong start. Starting usually Digister loves to block. I think as Rook you do gotta block on the majority of the time. But he starts with a pretty bold opening throw. Haven't seen Vengeful Pickle's Lum, or at least not often. Block, block, yep. That's the interaction I expected. Often taking knockdown as Rook and blocking is first a very good way to bait out reversals or fast attacks. The good thing about Lum in this matchup is that thanks to roll the dice, he can recur his fast attacks, so you can always threaten the fastest attack in the matchup. Well, I mean, the fastest attack in the matchup would be 0.4Q, but that doesn't have chip. This one has chip and can recur. And for all intents and purposes, this is the fastest attack, unless Rook has his AA, Wall of Vines. Unfortunately, though, he doesn't get it back. RTD made him get a bottom card from the deck instead. Fashionably late, Mystic Deadman. Not really late though, because the match started. Excuse me. Pardon me. So that's one J in discard. But, losing one J is not a big deal. Lum does have way. Yep. Got another J in reserve. Lum has way too many fast attacks for Rook to reasonably outspeed. Unfortunately, loses a 10 from RT roll the dice. You know, he does get the J back. Not a full hand. The Jester can certainly threaten rock armor. Rock armor, if you don't know. If you use a normal attack, you can discard two cards of the same suit to armor through the opponent's attack. So if Digister plays a 10 and is outspent, he can play two cards of that same suit to armor through the enemy's attack. Stone Wall is a good way to prevent Lum from recurring his options, even though it only does 4 damage back to him because it eliminates Chip. Both his 5 and his 3 can do that. Digicius is only thrown once, but that might be all he needs to establish fear in Vengeful Pickle for blocking. Yeah, Digicius is very patient as always. Does even power up actually. He chooses to discard. This is well known for blocking at full hand. The 4 attack, don't know if it's valuation, but might indicate that he might have awkward attacks now. Oh my god! Well, that was a good attempt. Silent CMB. I think I would have let that face down go if he only had 1k to follow up from it. But not a bad loss for Digister, honestly. Despite burning 4 aces, he got cards back from his Joker. So yeah, even after burning CMB, he has 11 cards in hand. Good job, Vengeful Pickle, for not dying. Realistically, Vengeful Pickle could honestly play attack the whole game until Digister rock armors and secures a sizable life lead. Right now, it's only they're only like 10, 15 HP apart. Yeah, he's going for huge stuff. See. Waiting for Digister to throw. But Digister is super patient. Is a very slow, patient matchup. Rook versus Lum is often a very tense standoff. I wonder if Vengeful Pickle will ever attempt a ballsy throw. Finally, a block from Vengeful Pickle. We haven't seen that yet. I mean, we've seen it turn one, and the turn he was knocked down, but other than that, he was playing attacks. As Lumpy, you don't have to throw, but it's good to represent throw once in a while, I think, when you have high hand as Lump. Especially against Rook with his propensity for blocking. We'll see though. Powers up for one ace. So Wall of Vines is not online yet. Entangling Vines, not a bad choice. Rook's special blocks are essentially dodges for him because he discards it after use. Interesting dodge there from Vengeful Pickle. I wonder what he wanted to dodge it to. Usually Lum doesn't have great dodge follow-up. He has Ks for his dodges. I think maybe he actually can dodge it to AA also. Depends on his hand. But usually his dodge volumes are kind of mediocre. I guess dodging into extra juice is viable as well. That silent CMB is so funny. Little bit hilarious it worked out. Wow. Speaking of silent aces, here's Ventral Pickles. Not all four, but two will do. Well timed. That was only the second time to register true. Well, excluding CMB. Think you're powering up? When will the digister go for a rock armor attempt? He's thrown once. Ooh, nice choice. That's another J, sent to the trash bin. Even life total is an even hand. Lum does have the better end game compared to Rook, though, because Lum has his out of combat damage that he's very infamous for. Four of a kind. Honestly, if he had a Poke Flourish, he could have just played a nine. But now he chooses to get aces. The deck. Yeah, he could have just. I think he could have just used the knight. He could just actually read. Let me read what Blackjack Poker Flourish does. Oh, he needs an ace in hand. Okay, I'm dumb. So he needs at least one ace to play and get the out of combat damage. 16, take it. Yep. So he powered all his nines to get aces in hand. Pitches two to the top of the discard, plays one for the four of a kind effect. If he had all four nines in hand and an ace in hand, he could have just used the nines for the four of a kind effect, I believe. Power up for another ace register? Yeah. Extremely patient matchup. And now Ventral Pickle has the lead. You need the life lead against Rook. Because playing against a Rook with life lead is quite scary, because he can just rock armor your attempts to close the gap. Ventral Pickle might have a Q here. No. He was looking for it. The Q is very scary for a Rook to deal with, because it is 0.4 speed. So even after you have Wall of Vines, it's no guarantee you have the fastest attack in the matchup. Actually, Lum's AA is 0.8 speed as well, so it does clash with Wall of Vines. CMB is online. I don't know if he'll try for it again, but Digister is a very calm, patient type, so I don't know if he's willing to drop it down again. Nice, block the Joker. Fortunately, Stonewall does not reflect any Joker damage back. It's a good time to Gold Burst. Unfortunately, Gold Burst is extremely safe against Rook, because Rook has no dodges, so he has no way to punish Gold Burst. Okay, powering up for aces. Yeah, here's another poker flourish. Powers up for the ace stats. Yep, for in discard. Now he can use four of a kind. Fourteen. Oof. Still got time for a comeback though. Vengeful Pickle's hand is deck is count is running low. Jackpot for to cycle through his deck. Timeout does favor Vengeful Pickle. Vengeful Pickle might have another Joker in hand. He wants to be completely safe from CMB, he might just Gold Burst. Or play Q. Oh, what a ballsy throw there. Doesn't pump it. That's the first throw we've seen from Vengeful Pickle all game. But he knew that Digister wasn't brave enough to attack or throw there. Oh yeah, attacking rock, even rock armor attempts is not safe because Lum has ace dodge. And ace dodge leads to unjokerable damage, unfortunately. Okay. Nice Windmill Crusher. Thankfully, that was not a Q. Activates roll the dice from it. It's crazy. That's a second Q. So now, this throws attacks are full four speed slower. This is still very tense. We have one more poker flourish left. Oh my goodness. He just does it. The Batman just unleashes CMB on a slowed down turn. Incredible. How does he do it? I don't know. Crazy. Crazy CMB. Well, Misty Devin does have a point. CMB was an ultimate comeback tool, but Vengeful Pickle didn't think he would get hit by it. I mean, it's not a bad play by Vengeful Pickle to play the 10th throw, because if he did land it, pumps it fully for 22, it would be game. Wow, Grappler Panda though. Just pumps it once, okay. Now timeout is favoring Digister. Digister might go for a rock armor attempt. It's possible. You have to be worried about ace dodge or even ace attack. Digister does have special blocks. Still left. Doesn't use them. Or might not have them. In hand right now, at least. Successfully blocks one Q. If they just play a rock armored 8 or 10, it's game over for Lum. He still has aces. He has Ventral Pickle has two aces, two mystery cards. Wow. Steadfast blocking. Knockdown. Now he no longer has the fuel to power up for aces. He only has two cards in hand. So this will make what we will see here potentially is 7 HP. Jackpot. Okay. Rock Armor Normals Online confirmed. Does Vegetal pick out the second Joker? He might Gold Burst here, actually, right now. I would Gold Burst here. Yeah, nice Gold Burst. I think I would have played a Rock Armor Normal there as well. But now, with aces in hand, Rock Armor Normals are no longer safe. The threat of the ace dodge is ever looming. Could this game end in a double KO? Is it possible? It certainly is possible. I think the ruling is if a double KO does happen, both players take one set. But if one player is a match point, then they have to replay the match. Pretty sure that's the ruling. Four. What was that four looking for? Oh. Actually, I don't know. What's that four looking for? I guess he was looking for fishing for a special block, perhaps. But he wasn't brave enough. If you want to fish for a special block, you might as well try and throw him, I think. If you were a special block, I would recommend to just throw him. No way. Blocking at 13 cards. Chipping him out though. And now he's slow. Is a crazy game one, am I right? Jesus. You can see Rock Armor here. I'm giving seeing a late game dodge here from Ventral Pickle. That Yeah, that's it. That's the ender. Wow. Insane. Just as Axes for lethal. Holy shit. That's just game one, fellas. That's just game one. Crazy. I honestly would have liked to see a late game dodge by Ventral Pickle. As soon as aces were down, dodge. Would have been cool. But the Digister does have jokers to make attacking the dodge is very safe. That's game one. Game two, will he stick with Lump? Or will he switch to BB? Don't worry about it, Ben. Full pick on recording. That was the longest game ever. But that's generally how the matchup does go. Very slow and grindy. Lum playing for the late game. Digister fishing for CMBs and big hits. But also lots and lots of blocking. I mean, you have to against Lum as a grapple character, as a slow character like Rook. Turn 1 Q is very bold. Fortunately, that cannot be recurred on block. There's no chip. Want to see some range shifts in this game. Maybe Digister might go more throw heavy. Damn, I would have thrown there. Sometimes you gotta establish a message, you know? Even if you get hit. But no, he sticks to his blocking plan, sticks to his guns. Going block with Lum is generally Lum wins, but Rook has the health and the rock armor to make sure that going block against Lum is not too bad. Nice. Typical. Now I reach a standoff here. Is this the third block turn? Can we see it? Nice. Goes for the ballsy throw. He played that one pretty quick. Palms with 3-2-4 for the extra damage. Now he has life lead, though the Digister has the card advantage. Lum can easily rebuild, though. To go for big duffs. Honestly, I'm not seeing a Rook block as much as Digister does. I think that's the secret to his success. His
Well,
patience, even when under pressure. Nice and Higgly Vines. Lum knockdown is very weak. Because you cannot try an ace dodge. You can still reversal, but knowing Digister, he can easily bait those out. Of course, Fetchable only has 5 cards in hand. He burned a lot going for throw damage on his 8. Okay. Triple ace power up. No big deal. Jackpot reveals a 5. Very scary here, Virtual Pickle. If he has a Joker, he might just Goldburst. Again, Goldburst perfectly safe against Rook. Digister might go for a, most likely he'll try to go for a cross up, I think. Cross up is 7. Well, the 4 with Entangling Vines, 4 so become 1.8 speed attacks, which are quite fast. Okay, wakes up with a 7. That's crazy. He didn't choose to use it for jackpot. I wonder why. Maybe that's his only available attack, or maybe he had 7, 8, I don't know. Interesting choice to wake up with a 7 there. Okay. Oh, okay. That explains everything. Jackpots are not hitting aces, unluckily for Vetrovickle. But jackpot is still a great ability, even if it doesn't hit ace, because you can see your opponent's hand and it cycles through the deck. Vetrovickle already got hit by CMB once. Don't know if he wants to get hit by it again. We'll see. So, the 7 attack was a mistake. Confirmed. He definitely has. Yeah. Definitely has fast attacks. Don't know if he can get much off of this. Most of his big, meaty normals are down. Never mind. He does have an 8 still. Doesn't recur to J, unfortunately, for him. But he slowed. Vlom only at 5 cards. Digister can take this opportunity to land some good hits. Either by throwing or just beating out throw attempts. Brave eventual to block there. Considering what happened last time on considering what happened last time on that roll the dice turn. Yeah, Stonewall. Probably anticipating a J or a Q. Q is a great card to have against Rook's double ace. Oh, okay. Fair enough. Good time to go burst. Now Digister only has AA. He doesn't worry about CMB anymore. Sorry, I don't want to give you guys a seizure. Oh, there's the anti-AA play. Power up. Why is he going for Poker Flares already? Bit early to make a Poker Flares, don't you think? I feel like maybe it would be better to keep AA for the threat of it at least. Because having only ace dodge, kind of scary against CMB or Wall Vines. No, he goes straight for the Book of Flares play. Team. Oh, risky. Bit risky, but that pays off. Now, Digister is 30 life down, but Vetropickle has a minuscule hand. One ace confirmed. Doesn't worry with double aces. Now might be a good time to CMB. Special Pickle could have another Joker here. Goldbursting here would be evil. No! Bravely blocks. Again. Another CMB opportunity lost, unfortunately. five blocks, definitely there to bait out potential Qs. Two Qs in discard though. Unlikely for him to have another. So check Wall of Vines would be the fastest attack here. This is CMB time. He could have done it. Windmill Crusher is a good throw to hedge against small-handed opponents. Because if he plays a 3 or 4, it would beat it. I mean, yeah, CMB would armor true. I mean, not CMB. Windmill Crusher would armor true trees, 3 and 4 attacks and beat it. Will Ventral Pickle have the nerve to continue blocking? CMB's still locked and loaded. But then there's a mix-up, you see. If you get you fear CMB and then you get hit by aces. Attack side at least. Ooh, nice five. Again, that K was to catch him blocking or playing a three or four. Normal. Gets knocked down. Loses the 10 for it though. Most of his windmill crushers have been expended now. Wake up, CMB? Oh, he tried it. I like that attempt. I like that attempt, I will say. Just because wake up AA seems so face up. Sick J6, we got panda combos. Unfortunately, he does not recur to J. Q makes him slow. So now at this stage of the game, with Lum only have 18 cards in discard, and a 40 HP life lead, it's tough to make a comeback. Even if he tries in rock armors here. Even if he tries rock armors, it's gonna be tough hill to climb. Nice. The 4K does pay off. Maybe the gesture will shift to a heavy throw range here. Since Lum still has a small hand. Yep. Here we go. Now he is docked down. He can tread and cross up. Rook's throws 10 damage it can combo, but does make them very efficient. I wonder what Ventral Pickle has in hand. I feel like he could have had a second Joker. Yeah. I saw that coming. Nice attempt at a cross up though. Still have two tens left. He's gonna try for a Poke Flourish now. Poke Flourish is perfectly safe. When your jokers are in discard, or if you got two jokers confirmed, not in deck. Because the unfortunate thing that can happen during Poke Flourish is you mill a joker when you while milling other cards. So that'll immediately bust you out. Oh, that's a 21. That's a 21. So as a reward, he gets all those cards back in hand. So now comeback for Digister is going to be extremely difficult. At least both jokers are down. Still going to be very difficult though. He has to make a series of correct combat reads. And rock armoring is, yeah, probably has a second K. Does have a joker though. But he still lives. KKK. Drawing his whole case down. Now he's slowed. Okay. Now he's threatening chip out with his aces. But Stonewall can still be a factor. If he has Qs, does he have Qs? He might have one Q. I'll probably play my Qs first if I had them. Oh. That's one Stonewall baited. Unfortunate. This might be where the AA comes for chip out. Still lives though. Tangling vines coming to save the day. Oh, not for much longer, though, unless he has more special blocks. Or a gold burst. Eight cards left. Powering up for aces might be a sign that he is checkmated here. Even a clash would not be good for him, because both aces clashes at 0.8 speed. Wake up, A. Up five. Damn, these games are crazy. He's just hoping and praying for. He only has 1-3 and 1-5 left. Just waiting for. If he can reflect, Pandemonium, 21 damage back in Ventral Pickle's face, he might make a comeback. Otherwise, it's looking grim. Wow. Blocks there. CMB confirmed. Five cards left. That was a fast face down. It's either a Q or ace ace, I bet. Coin toss? Good game. Coin toss would have lost to Wall of Lines. So, tiny bit risky to play that Jader. But hey, you know. So I guess, he was looking super hard for that special those special blocks. While still hedging against CMB, obviously. I think, how long is this recording? That's how the matchup goes. I feel exhausted already, and I'm not even playing. Pretty sure that's almost, we're almost running an hour. Almost an hour, and we only two games in. And still, the Jester steadfastly blocks. Gets the K back. That 3 chip from Portal Cartwheel does add up. I'm gonna keep spamming it. But it is only 3.4 speed. Okay, Nelly finds a attempt to get rid of the K. Think I would like to see the shift to a more heavy throw range. I feel like he did lose the game because he lost some throw attempts and some CMB attempts. Like going block with Lum. It's okay, kind of, but Lum still wins out block. So yeah, I would like to see a more heavy throw range. Miss some golden opportunities in that CMB in the second game, and some damage that he sorely needs. Damn, nice blocks. 3 chip. Still gets the K back. Couple more of those and Visual Pickle have life lead. But now Digister's 12 cards fully loaded up. If Digister can successfully prevent Ventral Pickle from going to the end game, milling all his cards, getting his jokers, if he can prevent Ventral Pickle from ending the end game, then it would be good for him. Oh? Straight? Okay. Interesting use of Pokéfloors there with the straight. Most likely he will fetch a Joker. Joker practically confirmed because that's the best card to have against Rook. Against a full hand Rook. Nice throw. There we go. Even if that's the only throw he's going to attempt. Throwing early like that. And landing it is a good way to shift the tempo. If they just throws again, it'll be good, in my opinion. Like, if I was Rook here, I wouldn't mind getting hit by attack. Distract the fear of God in him, Digister. I would have got hit by that K. But hey, maybe he has rock armor here. Damage. Rock armor? Unfortunately, he could have got more with a 10, but 10 of spades, but This does, 4 does undercut some big lum normals. This could very well be a real joker, but we'll see. Wow, nice bluff. Nice bluff. So forces Rook to expend 2 cards for rock armor. And he doesn't have much to show for it. 14 damage versus 4, and he doesn't even have to spend his Joker, which he definitely has because he searched his deck. If the Jester had a straight 4-5-6, then he probably would have played into it. But the risk of a Joker made him very wary to spend his resources. Looks like another rocket armor attempt here. QQ. That's a lot of damage for our DP. Real Joker? No. Interesting. He doesn't even face down. Oh, he had a straight. Even if he faced down here, he probably would have just played it for straight. Gets back 2 Qs, that's brutal. Qs are such a annoying tool that Rook has to deal with. Because it recurs. And because it's faster than anything he can play. Jackpot. First successful jackpot this game. Important to note, it reveals the Ace of Diamonds. Well, he got Ace of Clubs from the deck. So, Wall of Vines is confirmed. Life total is about even. Vegetable Pickle has a very scarily large hand. Brave block. Well, I wouldn't say brave, but the threat of Vegetable Pickle throwing there was definitely real. And with large hand Lum's throws, he can make Lum's throws hurt.
Darn it, baby! Also, I had beard on ever since, it's not there anymore. I don't know what happened with it.
Oh, does that record desktop audio? I should have done that. My bad. I had a stream open in the background. Dazzle hit play. It's an hour. I think we reached an hour mark for this match. Ooh, that's what I'm talking about. These throws right here. And he can pump it with 442. Lum can take advantage of the pumps here and pump cards that he wants to put in discard for Poke Flourish. Eighteen damage is not bad, even though it's quite card inefficient. Only 3 damage per card spent. It's not a big deal if Lum has a large hand. How is he gonna make this comeback? By blocking, that's how. I don't know how he can play Rook. This is what, if I played Rook, I would have been driven insane by how much I had to be, how patient I had to be, how much blocking I had to do. And that's the same J of Diamonds he revealed before. And he could keep spamming that. as a cue to perhaps undercut a Wall of Vines attempt. So this is just slowly rebuilding his hand. He still has a Joker he has to deal with, unfortunately. Oh, again, especially because lands these key throws. I know the Digister is very patient, but he is falling. Again, he's losing opportunities to throw VP or get damage in. And it's, in the long run, it's going to cost him. Well, there's one J down at least. He still has a Q though. Eventual pickle. And that Q will be very annoying. And he has to worry about the cold burst. It's tough being a rook player. It's really tough. Nice. This one cold burst down. Ace. CMB confirmed. He hasn't played any of his aces yet. So with one Joker in discard, it's one less just to worry about. This is where Vegetable Pickle could play his Q here just to be safe. But still got special blocks left. Three threes, two fives. Getting hit by these J's though. Well, I don't say hit, but again, the chip is annoying because if he gets at least if he just gets one chip, he can trigger roll the dice and get it back. So Vegetable Pickle still has to play his Q. Just the threat of the Q is enough to make the Digister scared. Yeah, this game, it seems that he's getting all the RTD he needs. Nice Wall of Vines. Great Wall of Vines. Gotta get rid of that annoying Jack. Yeah, he was waiting for it. So now he tried CMB again. Good. Meanwhile, Vegetable Pickle still has his Q in reserve, which he has not played. He pumped this Q a long time ago. Now he's within. Well, yeah, he was at 51 HP, but now he's within CMB lethal range. Not a bad Wall of Vines attempt, but second goal burst defeats that. Okay, interesting enough. Only gets one, but that's because he only has. Now he has all four aces in hand confirmed. If that AA lost, I think the AA, if that lost to his Q, that would have been even more painful, unfortunately. Wonder if Vegeta Piccolo will try for a cheeky throw here. He certainly. Oof. No, he just went straight for the pandemonium. Nice Joker. Bails him out, but it's good. It could still be game anyway if he has Poker Flourish. Well, that's one. I don't mind that cage throw there. Beating out sneaky throw attempts is something that bleh. In any case, this game is just such a grind. Okay, no Broken Flourish, it seems. I mean, he did put his Ks on top of his discard. Maybe a cross up. No, the blackjack dodge. Damn. Well played by Vengeful Pickle. That's a rough way to lose that game. Having your gold burst dodged. Rough. Yeah, why does he keep tapping II? I just realized that. And now I know. It's the Dvorak keyboard. It's a weird keyboard layout that is supposedly more intuitive than the QWERTY layout. But I'm too used to QWERTY to use anything else, as some of you, as most of you know. So, break time. Time to play some music. While these guys recharge. What's a good tune here? I know, how about some synth wave?
Seem to understand.
music interlude over. Back to the match. I had to take a water break myself because I'm pooped. My throat was dry, but now I'm good. This is going to be my longest video yet. Now the contestants come back refreshed. I wonder how this set is going to play out. Plays out with block block. Man! This is going to be another very long game, is it? But I suppose that's the matchup. This is a true battle of wills, I will say. Can the patience... Who has the greater patience? I can't believe the Jister is steadfastly blocking, as well as Ventral Pickle. Both steadfastly blocking. He needs to get some damage in early, I think, though. That's how you pressure Lum. But no, the third block indeed works out. The five hedge against the K throw. Nice bamboo art, I just realized. The duffing continues. Well, the attempt to duff continues. Considering he just played a 5 and a 6 back to back, I expect he has an ace behind, straight behind it. 5, 6, 7, 8 straight. Now he has no straight. Maybe. So Digster finds himself 13 cards versus 9 cards, healthy 100 HP life total. Ventral Pickle did win the backup last game, thanks to some cheeky throws. Don't know if he'll replicate that this game. Wow, Digster still blocking. Incredible. He's blocked 5 times in a row, yep. The patience of an absolute saint. Does get an ace. We don't know how many aces he really has in hand. But even one ace of power up is worrisome. Because CMB can sneak up on you. Oh, well, there's the throw attempt, and that's a big fat 8. Fast face down, fortunately, doesn't deter Ventral Pickle. 24 damage from 3 cards, and he gets the cube back. That's just cruel. That's just cruel. Because, you know, again, whenever Lum has Qs, it means he has the dominant attack. He's powering up for aces, but Wall of Vines doesn't matter in the face of the 0.4 speed queen. The mental guard crush is real, dealing with that card. That's why the matchup is so bad for Rook. 24 damage combo with normal draw, and with Q's coming back in hand. That's okay. 9Q. Flush. Ah, he draws 3 cards from it. So now he's at full hand. Oh, rough. Jackpot is turning up for him now. This is demoralizing. He got hit by 48 damage. No, 38 damage. No, 48. No, 38. Math. Got hit by 38 damage in the span of one turn. 15 cards. I wouldn't be surprised if Metropickle just plays his Q here. Or even a throw to cash out damage. Who knows how sadistic Ventral Pickle will be here. CMB now! He did it. That was the throw I'm talking about. I wanted him to CMB there, I really did. Fully pumped throw for 18. Pretty damn good. And he has full hand again. Federal Pickle does. Going to be a brutal comeback. Then again, only needs the one CMB. And he has life lead. If he can land it, of course. Or if Federal Pickle continue to bully him. It's not looking good for our hero, I will say. Okay, nice entangling vines. Doesn't help him though, because his he can't speed it up to a speed faster than 1.0. So he still loses to Wake Up Q. At least he can Rock Armor True Q. They just might try for Rock Armored Normal here. Or Wall of Vines. Damn. But again, he loses to. This is a known Q, unfortunately. But hey, Wake Up J or Wake Up Slow Normal is still certainly a thing. Or even Wake Up Throw. Thank God, he doesn't get it back though. Luckily for the Digister. Still a CMB. CMB and 4 mystery cards. If I get hit by the third Q, I would probably concede. I would be too mentally guard crushed to continue. But. Yep. Time for me to hit the concede button. Okay, he only has one. Does he get it back? He does! Yeah, bye. How's the for an ace? One good poke flourish. Just end things right here. No. It's time to digister. Time to go wild. Throw him. Throw him. Do it. Now is no time to sit and block. It's time to go in. Yeah. That's what I like to see. Suddenly it's much less scary to throw a book when he doesn't have CMB. Fishbook, I wanted to throw him, wanted to close the game with that 9 throw. CMB's still online though. CMBM, now! You know you want to. Sad thing is, even if he does land CMB, Vegetal Pickle will still have life lead. But I think you gotta go for it. No? Nice block on the gold burst. See, this is the kind of patience I don't have. Power for CMB and then to block. You know, it's such a huge life deficit. If you can bait out Vegetal Pickle's third Q, then he's in a good spot. Because he can actually threaten a fast attack. Oh yeah. Vegetal Pickle, did he power for aces? I bet he did. Actually, I don't know. Did he power up? The logs are... The client's lagging. Yep. Oof. I don't blame him going for that CMB. I really don't blame him. Slow down. At 12 HP. Honestly, there's no hope of coming back. Such a huge life deficit. Such a huge life deficit. Still with Poke Flourishes on deck. Yeah, I like the 8 throw was to close it out, but... Yeah. Slip chance that our hero is going to make a comeback. Because it's time for Vengeful Pickle to crush his hope and dreams right here. Only a lucky Joker could save him. Yeah, 12 HP is guaranteed kill territory. RIP. Ooh. Good games, everyone. Long set, but definitely was worth the watch. Well played to both players. Digister, you have the patience of a god. And Vegetal Pickle, your reads were on point. And you played the matchup textbook very well. I would like to see Digister, I think, go for more brave reads. More throws, just because going block with Lum is quite bad, especially as Rook. But, you know Rook better than I do, that's for sure. Well played to both players. Good games.